بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. أبنائي الأعزاء، طلبة وطالبات الصف الثاني الثانوي لغات، نلتقي اليوم وفي موضوع آخر إن شاء الله تعالى من موضوعات الماث، ولكن اليوم حنغير ونشتغل أبلايد ماث، حنشتغل ميكانيكس، حنشتغل في درس مهم جدا تابع للداينامكس. الدرس بتاعنا هو بعنوان، العنوان بتاعنا اسمه Variable Motion Street Motion with a Uniform Acceleration. Street Motion with a Uniform Acceleration. تعالوا نشوف ما معنى Variable Motion. Variable Motion means if a particle moves such that its velocity vector changes from an instant to another, and this change is either in magnitude or direction or both, then we say that this particle makes a variable motion or is moving with acceleration. Variable motion means a body or a particle moves and its velocity vector must be changed. Change in magnitude or in direction, or magnitude and direction. So this motion is called variable motion or the motion with acceleration. Definition of the acceleration vector. Acceleration حنرمز لها برمز E. it is the rate of a change of the velocity vector. This the concept or the meaning of the acceleration. عفواً the acceleration vector it is the rate of change of the velocity vector with respect to the time, or it is the change of the velocity vector in the unit of time, in the unit of time. So the acceleration A equal V minus V zero means V minus V zero means change in velocity. V means the velocity at the end of motion. V zero means the velocity at starting or the beginning of motion over T minus T zero equal V minus V zero over T. So the acceleration A equal V minus V zero over T. Change in velocity over change in time. Units of measuring acceleration. The first unit of measuring acceleration is kilometer per hour per second. And the second unit is meter per second per second. And can we write it meter per second square? We have another unit it is centimeter per second per second. Can we write it centimeter per second square? Now if you want to change from a unit of measuring acceleration to another unit, you must learn the following converting. The following changes. Number one, if you want to change from kilometer per hour per second to meter per second square, you will multiply by 1000 over 60 times 60. And its simplest form is 5 over 18. So if you want to change from kilometer per hour per second to meter per second square, you will multiply by 5 over 18. If you want to change from kilometer per hour per second to centimeter per second square, you will multiply by 1000 times the 1 times 100 over 60 times 60, and its simplest form is 250 over 9 centimeter per second square. So if you want to change from kilometer per hour per second to centimeter per second square, you will multiply by 250 over 9. If you want to change or to convert from meter per hour per second to centimeter per second square, you will multiply by 100 over 60 times 60 equals 1 over 36 centimeter per second square. Now we will learn three important laws, very, very important. Important rules. The first rule tell us the relation between the initial velocity and the ending velocity, or final velocity and time and acceleration, v equal v0 plus at. And this rule is produced from the definition of the acceleration, the previous definition of the acceleration. We have another rule, s equal v zero t plus half a t square. S here means the distance, equal v zero t plus half a t square. We have a third rule, v square equal v zero square plus 2as. Now we learn the meaning of each of these symbols from the following list. V0 is the initial velocity or the velocity at the starting motion. V only is the final velocity or the velocity at the ending of motion. A means acceleration, S means distance, T means time. Now we have some examples. The first example, say a particle starts its motion in a constant direction with velocity 9 centimeter per second and with a uniform acceleration of magnitude 3 centimeter per second square, acts in the same direction of the initial velocity. So the acceleration and the velocity at the same way, in the same direction. Find number A, the velocity of the particle after 5 seconds from the starting of the motion. The second, find the time it takes from the starting of the motion until its velocity become 54 centimeter per second. First of all, you must learn what are the givens in our problem. The givens are, we have initial velocity v0 equal 9, we have also the acceleration equals 3, and we have the time to solve the first part of our question. The first part, t equal 5 seconds, and the final velocity or the velocity at the end of motion is unknown. How can we find the velocity? By using the first rule, which is v equal v0 plus at. By using the direct substitution, v0 equals 9 and a equals 3, and also time t equal 5, so we can find v equal 9 plus 3 times 5 equals 24 centimeter per second. Now how can we find the time taken from the starting motion until its velocity becomes 54. Now we have another given, v equal 54 centimeter per second. V here means the final velocity. T is the required, and also we know v0 equal 9 centimeter per second, and a equal 3 centimeter per second square. So we can find that E also by using the first rule, V equal V0 plus 80, by using the direct substitution, V equal 54 V09 plus the acceleration 3 times T. So we can find T equals 54 minus 9 and divided by 3, so T equal 15 seconds. The time equal 15 seconds in the second required. I have another example. Number 2, a particle moves in a straight line, so its velocity changes from 54 kilometer per hour into 3 meter per second in half a minute. Find the magnitude of the acceleration of the motion. Now you must know what are you're given in this problem, and you must mix the units. All the units are the same. Note the velocity, the first velocity, its unit kilometer per hour, but the second velocity is meter per second. You must change one to the other. The first velocity V0 equal 54 kilometer per hour, and the second V equal 3 meter per second, and the time T equals 0.5. So what can we do? We can change the velocity, the initial velocity from kilometer per hour to meter per second, or you can change from meter per second to kilometer per hour, up to you. I prefer change from the greatest unit to the smallest unit, so we can change from kilometer per hour to meter per second. The acceleration now, we need it. First of all, V0 equal 54 kilometer per hour. We multiply it by 5 over 18 to change it into meter per second. So 54 times 5 over 18 equals 15 meter per second. Now we have V0, we have V final, we have time, so we can find the acceleration using also the first rule. So you must change the time from minutes to seconds. 0.5 minutes equal 30 seconds. The first rule, V equal V0 plus 80. V here is 3 equal 15, which is V0 plus A. Times in the time equal 30, so we can find the acceleration A equal 3 minus 15 divided by 30 equal negative 2 over 5 meter per second square equals negative 0.4 meter per second square as a decimal. لاحظ هنا الاكسلريشن بالنيجاتيف ليه؟ لان هنا الفيلوسيتي قلت. الفيلوسيتي كانت في البدايه 15 متر اصبحت 3، يبقى في هنا يعني الفيلوسيتي طالما هتقل يبقى اكيد الاكسلريشن ايه لازم تبقى بالنيجاتيف، وبنسميها في الحاله ديت ديسيلريشن، بنسميها هنا ايه ديسيلريشن. I have another example, number 3. A particle started its motion in a straight line with uniform acceleration 5 centimeter per second square and initial velocity 20 centimeter per second in the opposite direction of its acceleration. You must put a line under the opposite direction. Find its velocity and displacement after 3 seconds. What are our given in this problem? We have acceleration equals 5 centimeter per second square, but you must make its sign is negative because the acceleration and the initial velocity in opposite direction. So the initial velocity V0 equal 20 centimeter per second, A equal negative 5 centimeter per second square, and T equal 3 seconds. The required is V final and the displacement. We can find first of all the final velocity from the first rule v equal v0 plus at v equal v0 plus at so using the direct substitution v0 equals 20 a equals negative 5 t equal 3 so v equal 20 plus negative 5 times 3 equals 5 centimeter per second. Now we can find the displacement using the second or the third rule, because we have v0, we have acceleration, we have time, we have final velocity. So any one of the other two rules can solve the problem. Since s equal v0 t plus half a t square, by using the direct substitution v0 equal 20 times the time 3 plus half times the acceleration negative 5 times t square, which is 3 all power 2. So we can find the s here equals 37.5 centimeter. Now I have another example. Number 4. A particle moves in a straight line with a uniform acceleration 2 centimeter per second square in the same direction of its motion after covering 2.25 meter. Its velocity becomes 50 centimeter per second. Find its initial velocity. Who can tell me what can we do? First of all, you must learn, you must know what are the given. The given, you have acceleration, you have its final velocity, and we have also the covering distance. The distance equals 2.25 knots. It is in meter units, in meter a unit. So the given again, a equal 2 centimeter per second square, v equal 50 centimeter per second. Notes again s in meter, so you must change s from meter to centimeter. So s equal 2.25 meter equals 225 centimeter, and v0 we will find it. It is the required. So we can using the third row, which is has no time, which has no e, no time. V square equal v zero square plus two a s, because this rule has no time, has no e, no t. So using the direct substitution, v equal 50. So 50 square equal v zero square plus 2 times the acceleration عندنا هنا 2 times s equal 225. By using or by solving this problem, v0 square equal 2500 minus 900 equals 1600 or 1600 by taking the positive square root. So v0 equals 40 centimeter per second. Now I have another example. Sorry, we can use drawing a diagram help us in our problem like this. Initial velocity v0 has a question mark, isn't exist. V equal 50 meter. We have a here. We have s also equal to 125 centimeter. Like this diagram, you can use someone of like it to solve the problem. We have another example, number 5. Number 5 tell us a car moves in a straight line when its velocity was 72 kilometer per hour. It used brakes. Brakes here means الفرامل بتاعت الكار. It used the brakes. It moved with retardation motion. Retardation motion means deceleration. motion of uniform variable till its velocity becomes 54 kilometer per hour. Notes the initial velocity 72, the final velocity 54, so the velocity decreases, so we can deduce the acceleration must be in negative direction or in opposite direction. After a distance 140 meter, find the acceleration and the cover and the covered distance from the starting motion till it become at rest. Please be carefully, so because we have two stages here. The first stage like this diagram, V0 equals 20 meter per second. I changed the initial velocity from 72 kilometer per hour into meter per second. The final velocity equal 15 and S here equal 140. So we can find the acceleration in this stage. So the given again of this stage, V0 equals 72 kilometer per hour, multiplying it by 5 over 18 equals 20, and V final equal 54 kilometer per hour, multiply it by 5 over 18 equals 15, and S1 here equal 140 meters. So we can find the acceleration using this rule, V square equal V0 square plus 2AS. V here equals 15, 15 square equal V0 square, which is 20, 20 square plus 2 times E times S, which is 140. So 15 square equal 20 square plus 2AS. Please don't forget the acceleration here must be in negative sign. So you can solve the previous equation to find the acceleration equal negative 5 over 8 meter per second square. Now after finding the acceleration, we can use it in the second stage. Note the second stage, after covering the distance 140 meter, the final velocity of the first stage must be is the initial velocity or the starting velocity of the second stage. And notes in the second stage, the final velocity must be equal zero, like this diagram. Okay, like this diagram, V0 equal 15, V final equal zero, and S2 unknown. And we learn, or we have now also the acceleration, which is we get from the previous stage. So the given in the second stage, V0 here equal 15, V final equal zero, S unknown, and A equal negative 5 over 8. So we can find S in the second stage using the same rule, V square equal V0 square plus 2AS. V square, V equal 0, 0 equal 15 square plus 2 times A negative 5 over 8 times S. So we can find S here, S here equal equal 180 meter. Don't forget the question is find the distance from the beginning of motion until it becomes at rest. So we have two stages. The total distance equal the distance in the first stage plus the distance in the second stage. So the total distance equal 140 plus 180 equals 320 meters. I have another example. I think this is the last example. A car applied its brakes when its speed was 45 kilometer per hour to decrease its speed to 18 kilometer per hour after it covers 525 meter. Find the time taken to cover this distance and the time taken after that until the cars stopped. Notes here, you use also a diagram like this. V initial V0 equal to 12.5 meter per second after converting it from kilometer per hour to meter per second, and the V final also 5 meter per second after converting it. We have a distance is equal 525. Now we can find the acceleration first. We can't find the time firstly, but we can find the acceleration first. So we have also two stages. The first stage, it's given like this, V0 equal to 12.5 meter per second, V final equal 5 meter per second, is as we said 525 meter. The acceleration and the time are unknown, but we can find the acceleration firstly. We can find the acceleration using V square equal V0 square plus 2AS. So V5 square equal 12.5 all square plus 2 times 8 times 525. So we can find the value of the acceleration A equal negative 1 over 8 meter per second square. So we can find the time from the first rule, V equal V0 plus AT. We have V equal 5 and V0 12.5, and A now is negative 1 over 8. So we can find the time, which equal 60 seconds, or maybe you can change it to minutes, 1 minute. This is the first stage. In the second stage, after covering the distance 525, we want to find the time needed to until the car stopped. So in the second stage, V final must be 0 and V0 must be is the value of V in the first stage. So in the second stage, like this diagram, V0 here equal 5, V final equal 0, and the acceleration equal negative 1 over 8. So we can find the time taken in this stage, or the time needed in this stage. The time needed, we can find it from the first rule, V equal V0 plus AT, V equal 0, and V0 equal 5 plus negative 1 over 8T, so T here equal 40 seconds. Notes S here is not required. You can find it, but it is not required here. أبنائي الأعزاء، أنا وصلت معكم إلى ختام موضوعنا اليوم. أتمنى من الله سبحانه وتعالى أن نكون قد استوعبنا منه إن شاء الله بعض الشيء. اللهم إن كان هناك توفيق فمنك وحدك، لا إله إلا أنت سبحانك، وإن كان هناك سهو أو نسيان أو تقصير فهذا مني ومن الشيطان. والسلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته، وألقاكم في لقاء آخر.